Welcome back, everybody. There is new DNA evidence giving fresh hope to the case of American student Amanda Knox. She is appealing her murder conviction in Italy. A leaked court report is now revealing that forensic experts are rejecting a key piece of evidence in this trial. Gregg Jarrett live in our New York newsroom with more on this. Gregg.
Hi, Martha. The DNA evidence that helped convict Amanda Knox was always shrouded in controversy and serious doubt. But now, well, it could be thrown out completely, which may mean a new trial, and this time a not guilty verdict. Knox, who is 23 years old, is serving 26 years in an Italian prison for a crime she insists she did not commit. Now, at trial, prosecutors claimed that her DNA was on the murder weapon, the knife. There it is. But now, an independent analysis of that knife by two court-appointed experts has found that the DNA was so minuscule, so scant, that, quote, it has proved to be insufficient to convict. Well, the victim, 21-year-old Meredith Kircher of Great Britain, was found with her throat slit, lying semi-naked on the floor of a rented Italian home. The clasp of her bra was said to have Knox's DNA on it, but now the new scientific review says that was so deteriorated that it was impossible to test for DNA. Knox was fingered for the crime by a nefarious figure, a guy by the name of Antonio Curatola, who claimed he saw her at the murder scene. And he said, I distinctly remember the night because young people were waiting nearby for a bus. Well, guess what? Turns out there were no buses that night. It was a holiday. Italian trials have none of the protections that are given to a defendant in American courtrooms. The trial was widely criticized as shoddy and sloppy. But that didn't stop Lifetime TV from airing a movie last month depicting Amanda Knox as a heinous killer, when in fact the true evidence, Martha, may eventually prove otherwise. Wow.